just a paper lunch bag and a pair of scissors. First, what we're going to do is we're going to cut strips from all the way to this line here. So from the opening of the bag to the line, they don't have to be any specific size. They don't even have to be particularly straight. So we'll just cut those lines right up there. Then, once we have what looks like an octopus, we're going to open up our bag. And you need to kind of do this gently. Just put your hand right in there. Open it up. Got a jellyfish or something here. Turn it this way. And we are going to grab all of the little strings and push down with our fist. And we're going to twist and twist and twist. And you'll see now we are making the base of the tree and the trunk. So we want to twist that up nice. And there's no right or wrong way to do that. You just want to do it. The only trick is don't rip it. Now you've got all these different pieces here. What I like to do is take two different pieces and then twist them together. So I'm just going to twist. And again, the only trick here is to not rip. Right? And you know what? This is good fine motor skills for anybody you're working with. I was working recently with a client of mine who has a lot of arthritis in her hand, and even though at first she said it was painful, she really said it was actually kind of good exercise for her. So if you're working with kids who need to develop their fine motor skills, it's good. Recently I did this with a client of mine who has ADHD. And she was really, she hadn't had her medicine that day. And she grew bored after a while. And so I just helped her finish the project. And while she was finishing this project, twisting the branches, I had her cutting out with construction paper different colors leaves. And eventually she glued those on. So you can see I'm getting some branches going here. We'll just keep going with that. Now you can take this a step further and you can cut out construction paper or even use cotton and glue it on so you have leaves or snow on there. I've also taken some wire and wrapped it around to create colors and keep it really nice and tight. And this is just another way of creating a tree. We're used to tree drawings, but this is another way to create a tree. And we can ask the same kind of questions. Who takes care of the tree? Where does the tree live? What type of tree is it? Are there other trees around it? And you can really start a really interesting conversation as well as get them to really think more three-dimensionally. Thanks for joining me again for 3-Minute Art Therapy. And I hope to see you again real soon.